பேசி நல்லதாக இருக்கலாம்.
Actually, 2007 is the actual turning point for the.
Yeah, I was here from 2007 to 10 as CP.
Okay.
At that time, I knew that this was done for the
management. They started expanding various programs and then now working courses.
Okay.
And we have started campuses in Hyderabad as well as in Bangalore also.
Yeah.
Last time we met there, sir, in NIBM.
Yeah,
sir.
Yeah. We collected a salary? So that we see straight. This guide that you don't see sideways.
This is your knowledge source center of where you know the areas. Likewise, you need to have a presentation of the areas. Are the ACES and training?
Okay, ready, sir.
Can you raise? Under his able leadership, DSFL has transferred its successful journey with the shrimp hatchery in Kakinada, Black Tiger Shrimp Culture, a breakthrough entry into US market with a value-added product. Strategic alliance with Darden, outstanding the customer acceptance, its sales turnover, net worth 671 crores as on 31st March of 23%. Sri Pramandam has a vision to help the society at large and SMEs in particular through asset reconstruction business model, helping small businessmen who are in the household women responsibility through supporting employees' housing and children education, sponsoring schemes in surrounding villages for safe drinking water, and supporting a school in Kovur near Rajmundry with 300 children. From the personal perspective, the family of Sri Brahmanandam consists of his spouse, Srimati P. Suryavati, and two daughters, namely Ms. P. Ramadevi and Ms. P. Navina, who are the alumni of Geetam. Sri Brahmanandam is a first generation entrepreneur and a leader, and in recognition of this significant achievements in entrepreneurship and business leadership, the school confers on him the Fellow of the School.
Thank you.
respond.
See, VK Vijay Kumar, you are guest of honor. Management team and faculty members of Geetham, MBA and PGDBA pass outs from the school participating in the graduation event, and their proud parents present here, and also friends and family. I am greatly excited to be among you all this morning, the momentous ninth grade. I never imagined I am going to be on the billboard. I feel it is a matter of pride for me to be eligible for such a great honor from Geetham, the most respected and renowned organization engaged in the noble cause of creating enormous academic talent to take part in India's global wealth creation over the last three decades. There were times I wished I was a student of this university, which I had it fulfilled through my two daughters, both of them being graduated from this campus. Thanks again to JSAB for awarding me this fellowship. I congratulate and offer my best wishes to the graduating students of both the academic streams. This is a dream coming true occasion which brings you all a sense of achievement and fulfillment, and is the harvest of tremendous amount of hard work and sacrifice of you, your teachers and your parents for the last 2 years. I am happy to participate in this joyful occasion with you all and share the festivity. I was like you 40 years back. It reminds me of my graduation ceremony. The next day of my graduation, I was confronted with a big question, which I am sure is equally relevant for all of you. That is, what next? So, with you tomorrow onwards, it is not so easy to choose among various career options like business, profession, self-employment, academics, service, etc. It is just not about picking up a stream of earning money to make a living. Rather, it is a decision in the last 40 years to have regretted my decision for choosing a particular path of life. It gives me immense satisfaction and feeling of fulfillment that I build a globally acclaimed business enterprise providing a livelihood for about 3,000 workforce, offering a helping hand to the much adored farming community where my organs are putting up an annual turnover of more than 2,000 crores. 2,000 rupees of seed capital provided by my father in the year 1978 grown into a worth of 700 crores in the process. More frequently, I am asked to tell about the constitutive and cardinal principles and practices that I followed in my business journey all along toward on to such a long streak of success for more than 40 years. Honestly, I don't have any apt or academic answer for this question. I sincerely believe business virtues and traits are no different from character virtues and business traits. What is ideal for your as a good social being is also ideal for your business. The virtues like honesty, sincerity, hard work, prudency, compassion, empathy, ethical conduct. Successful, these qualities are imperative and essential no matter what career you choose to go after. It is not just enough. Academics are uniform and equal to every person, but not all of them are successful in their business life. There are many other virtues and qualities which I mentioned a while ago that distinguish between the successful and unsuccessful. Leave aside academic faculties, I would like to briefly touch upon the certain principles which made all the difference to my business and its progress to asset all over the years. Number one, importance of woman asset. Given everything else to be common, woman asset makes successful and unsuccessful enterprise. It's all about keeping your employees' morality at elevated level all the time. My employees are continuously moving, but also in their social and family life. Secured and satisfied employee leads is best to the organization, and I always believe in this proposition. And do not hesitate to do whatever it takes to keep up their morale high all the time. I have many employees working for me for more than 25 to 30 years who believe I have the priority in relationship. I have been immensely benefited and rewarded for adhering to this principle at every stage of my business. I have seen a customer offering me a business 2 to 3 crores in the year 1997-98, growing up to patronize me with a 400 crore business in latter years because of the relationship. As well, I recall the experience of a customer who was a hard nut to crack and with whom my business blossomed from 50 crores to in the year 2007-8 to 650 crores in 2017-18. Illustrations of this kind are many in my business journey. There were times I took crores of rupees hit by my bottom line just to maintain the relationship going on intact. And it was immensely rewarding, I admit. Thirdly, I have always chosen the road less traveled. What in psychology is called out of box thinking. I presume you better understand that this and do not need elaboration. I took a bold initiative in the year 1998-99 to set my sights on the USA market and value-added seafood production, isolating myself from the global export markets like Japan and Europe. And it paved way my peace to follow in the later years. And imagine today, India ranks first in frozen seafood supply to the USA, overtaking gates like China, Thailand, Vietnam. Further, mine was the first company from India to have set up its own distribution network in USA food service market in the year 2005-06 by forging direct supply alliance with America major food service companies. Furthermore, we are the forerunners in relationship, rationalizing the ration supply trade in Andhra Pradesh in the year 2006-07 with a view to extend a helping hand to the farming community who were struggling with the unorganized trade system in the clutches of middlemen. My company introduced instantaneous payment system to the farmers way back in 2006-07. The legacy of which is still continuing and turned out to be a standard in the industry. Taking different course is worth its risk, and my experience has always rewarded. The next principle is commitment to the core business. All over the years, I am committed to a business where I believe my core strengths are in. For more than 25 years, I am confined to business only. So the process of backward and forward integration. I believe the conventional saying of don't be jack of all trade and most of none. Coming to next, low financial leveraging has always been one of my core principles underlying my business. Since its beginning, my business has always been in profit with good amount of cash in the balance sheet. Opportunities have always cropped around me to make money by getting into unfamiliar ventures, even in the existing business too. But I never had the temptation to go after them and deploy my core business of uninterrupted resource allocation. I avoided debt always in my balance sheet, and what I own has always been my own. Going to next, adapt to the change is what I always embarked on. Business operates in a complex set of conditions which are constantly under to change, and unless you learn to live with it, you lose your existence and identity. This is more so in the present globalization world. There has been complete change in every 5 years in basic factors in my business, like technology, raw material availability, consumer preference, demand scenario for the products, the geographical shift in markets, associated laws and regulations, etc. We outlived all these imminent and changing trends, and at Devi, we all know change is the only permanent thing in the world, and we stay geared up to handle it to our advantage. I think I am crossing the time allotted to me and let me stop here. As mentioned earlier, I am not here to bother you debating up the academic concepts of a successful business, because they are all what we have already learned in your classroom through your study. I just wanted to let you know, out of my experience, that the principles which are equally important for you to hold on to a successful business career, although you are a double life. At the cost of repetition, I once again say, they are not the business phenomena at all, and derive their origin from normal human ethics and conventional prudence and wisdom. Thanks, one and all, for your patient hearing, and wish you all the best. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Let the recipients of the medals and cash awards be now presented.
President's Gold Medal, Mr. Konisetty.
Thank you.